Then the cat brings a large box into the house, and we get an actual reference to the book. Sadly, I think there are fewer of those than there are inappropriate jokes. He opens up the box, and out come Thing 1 and Thing 2. Conrad tries to look inside the crate, but the cat quickly puts a stop to that and locks it up. The cat then tells the Things to clean up the house. Unfortunately, the Things always do the exact opposite of what they're told, and they proceed to destroy everything. During the chaos, Conrad easily picks the lock. How does a 12-year-old know how to do that? The lock ends up on the dog's collar for some reason, which somehow leads to the Things throwing the dog out the window, and it runs for the hills once again.
Run for your life, doggy. Don't look back.
The cat explains that this is a very bad thing because if they don't lock that crate, some cosmic, supernatural, slimy energy will leak out and destroy the world or something. I don't know. They're clearly making this shit up as they go. So they use the comatose babysitter to keep the crate shut while they run out to find the dog. They actually find it pretty quickly, but of course the cat does something stupid and screws it up.
All right, Nevins. Time to die.
Cat, you scared him away.
Dirty hoe.
I'm sorry, baby. I love you.
Come on, cat.
You know, this is real... Shh. Can you hear that? That is the sound of Dr. Seuss rolling in his grave.
They then stumble upon a birthday party, and as the children start to run out of the house, the cat realizes he has to hide. Rather than do the sensible thing and hide behind a bush with Conrad and Sally, he disguises himself as a piñata.
Everybody join in!
This is what the audience wished they could do to the producers after seeing this movie. The cat nearly blows his cover after a well-placed shot to the jewels, but Conrad easily distracts them with candy. Perhaps a little too easily.
Oh my god. Is that a 6 foot tall talking cat? Ooh, candy! What were we talking about?
Unfortunately, Quinn shows up out of nowhere, grabs a dog, and drives off. So the cat decides to give chase in his own car. Which is a Hummer H2?
That's just the dust cover. Here she is, the super luxurious omnidirectional whatchamajigger.
S-L-O-W?
Yeah, slow. It's better than the last name we had. Super hydraulic instantaneous transporter.
Oh, you mean...
No! Quick to the slow!
They make it to downtown Anvil, and using a disguise that wouldn't fool a blind man, they manage to trick Quinn into handing over the dog. Then they run for it and take cover in what appears to be a public toilet, and then...
Look out, Butler! Oh!
What? How did this... Son of a... How did they slid down and they go and Paris Hilton? Paris Hilton? Why Paris Hilton? Why is she, why, who the, what is go, why the, just, how, why, what, who, where, when, fuck. Yeah, that just happened. I don't know what it was, but it happened. No. That only works if the movie makes sense in the first place.
Suddenly, Conrad gets a bright idea. He calls for the Things to not come and help them, and since the Things always do the opposite of what they're told, and since they can apparently hear you when you're miles away, they show up and give them a lift home. But when they get there, they find Quinn waiting for them. They go inside, and much to their surprise, the house is spotless.
Why am I sneezing?
That'd be me.
Yeah, kids in 2003 are totally gonna get that reference.
What happened to our house?
It's been turned into crappy CGI!
So they climb on top of their still snoozing babysitter, and the movie pretty much turns into a theme park ride.
You might think that since Universal was involved in the production, that this is a subtle advertisement for one of their theme parks. And you'd be wrong. There's nothing subtle about this.
This is amazing! It's like a ride in an amusement park!
You mean like at Universal Studios?
Cha-ching! The movie may have sucked, but hey, come check out the ride! Universal, go screw yourselves.
They find the crate and close it, and the house goes back to normal. Just before this happens. Oh, and Quinn somehow ends up outside the house covered in purple slime.
This slime is positively charged. He'll wake up feeling like $1 million.
At this point, the kids have finally had enough and tell the cat to get the fuck out. He reluctantly agrees. So the kids prepare for the impending arrival of their mother and most certainly their doom along with it. But if you remember how the book ends, you know what happens next. The cat and the things come back and clean up the mess, leaving the house as it was when they found it. They leave just before Joan comes home. Quinn comes in and makes an ass out of himself, causing Joan to kick him to the curb. Joan's meet and greet goes off without a hitch, and Conrad and Sally learn a valuable lesson.
Never let stray cats into the house. Especially if they're 6 feet tall, wear huge hats, and look like the guy from Austin Powers.
It's no wonder the widow of Dr. Seuss proclaimed she would allow no more live-action adaptations of her late husband's work after this steaming cat turd hit theaters. Naturally, this movie was nominated for several Golden Raspberry Awards, 8 in fact, but due to some stiff competition from Geely, and I'm dreading the day when I finally sit down and watch that, it only managed to take home one award. Worst excuse for an actual movie. All concept, no content. That pretty much describes The Cat in the Hat to a T. It's pretty clear that the writers of this movie said, hey, let's make a movie about The Cat in the Hat. And that's where the creative process stopped. Apart from a few moments borrowed from the book, it was nothing more than a mess of unfunny and inappropriate jokes and sight gags. It's really too bad, because I do like Mike Myers, Alec Baldwin, and Dakota Fanning, and they all turned in decent performances, all things considered. But there was nothing they could do to save this script. And the people who wrote it need to be beaten senseless with a moss-covered three-handled family redunda.
Well, that's the end of my review, which I hope you all enjoyed, even though this movie may have left you feeling quite annoyed. If you don't like my opinion, two tears in a bucket. I am the Smeghead, and Hollywood can suck it. Break the law.